At this time, I would like to introduce to you a very special gentleman and friend of mine, a firefighter and paramedic of 22 years and founder of Firefighters for 9/11 Truth, claiming now 116 firefighters on the petition, Mr. Eric Lawyer.
Thank you very much. And like Richard said, my name is Eric Lawyer, and I founded the Firefighters for 9/11 Truth after I watched Richard in one of his presentations, and I realized that something more had to be done. And I just want to thank Richard for everything he's doing here, and the Firefighters for 9/11 Truth strongly support Richard Gage and all the architects and engineers that have the courage to sign that petition. And I know from personal experience, there's about five times as many out there that believe what we believe but don't have the courage to sign it. So what I'm hoping today is that people will find the courage after listening to this presentation and seeing everybody here and seeing that we are behind it. We also demand an investigation that follows the national standards and has contempt and subpoena powers. 9/11 was the greatest loss of life and property damage in U.S. fire history. This should have been the most protected, preserved, over-tested, and thorough investigation of a crime scene in world history. Sadly, it was not. What was it? Well, we know from their own admission, the majority of the evidence was destroyed. I, like Richard said, 22 years of experience, I've seen a lot of crime scenes, I've never seen anything like this in my life. I was out at the site, I saw trucks leaving faster than, you know, anywhere I've ever seen, but I accepted it at the time, and for years I accepted it, because it was a recovery and rescue operation, and that's normal to have something like that going. Again, we never seen anything like it, but that was expected. What I didn't know for years, what was going on behind the scenes, was that evidence was being destroyed when it was shipped off. By their own admission, this investigation of Tower 7 had no physical evidence. How do you investigate a crime when you've destroyed all the evidence? It doesn't make sense. They also admit that they refused to test the explosives, or to test for explosives, or residue of thermite. Now, this is what I'm going to go into here just real quickly, is there are national standards for an investigation. That's what all of us are asking for, an investigation that follows national standards and holds people accountable. This manual right here, just so you can see it, is what we call the Fire Investigation 101. This is the most basic fire investigation manual there. This is for the 2001 edition. This is what should have been referred to, at least. It doesn't have to be followed exactly, but it should have been used as a guideline for the investigation. I'm just going to cover a few of the things that are in here. So NIST violated, and the initial investigators that did not protect the scene violated, the most basic of the guidelines. And I'm going to cover five of them here. One is the NFPA 9.3.6. It covers spoliation of evidence. What it reads is, once evidence has been removed from the scene, it should be maintained and not destroyed or altered until the investigation is complete. The steel was melted down prior to the investigation. We know that from their own admission. This is no conspiracy theory stuff. 19.2.4, exotic accelerants. If on the scene you find melted steel or concrete, you should consider the use of exotic accelerants. And they specifically say in the manual, thermite mixtures produce exceedingly hot fires that can account for melted steel and concrete. That also says they leave residues that can be tested for visually and chemically identifiable. Again, they did not test for it. And just put it in perspective, on a routine house fire, if we suspect even the slightest use of an accelerant, we're going to test for it when there's no fatalities, when there's very little property damage. So to not do it on this, there is absolutely no excuse. I can't drive that point home enough. 18.15 is analyze fuel source. All available fuel sources should be considered and eliminated until one fuel can be identified as meeting all the physical damage criteria. For example, if you find pulverized concrete, which we all know there was in all three buildings, there was pulverized concrete, the only fuels that can create seated explosions should be considered. So they shouldn't be considering fires. They shouldn't be doing that. It doesn't account for pulverized concrete. They should only be considering exotic accelerants and explosives. 19.4.8.2.6, extremism. The terrorist may include fire as but one of a variety of weapons, along with explosives, used in furthering his or her goal. We know they used them in 93. Why would we not test for them now? There was reports that day, multiple reports, which I'll get into in a second, so they could have put them in the basement. How do we know that unless we test for it? I mean, even if it is the terrorist that they claim they are, we need to test this. 14.3, preservation of the fire scene and physical evidence. We find the following. The cause of a fire explosion is not known until near the end of the investigation. The entire fire scene should be considered physical evidence and should be protected and preserved. It's just over and over. There's so many. You can go to our website, the Firefighters for 9/11 Truth. We have many more of these actual chapters that cover what they should have done that they did not do. So now, by their own admission, in all three building collapses, NIST refused to physically test, like Dr. Stephen Jones did, for explosives. This is just unbelievable. And here are their excuses, and I quote, "It is unlikely that 100 pounds of thermite or more could have been carried into World Trade Center 7 and placed around columns without being detected, either prior to September 11th or during that day." So again, I've been on a lot of fire scenes, and I've seen a lot of investigations, and why would we not test because something's hard to do? That's the exact reason you need to investigate it. If that was hard to do, we need to find out how they did it. And number two, NIST excuse. In addition, no blast sounds were heard on the audio tracks of the video recordings during the collapse of World Trade Center 7 or reported by witnesses. That's one of the excuses why they didn't test. Well, apparently they didn't read Chapter 18. 18 is the general definition of explosions. Although an explosion is almost always accompanied by the production of a loud noise, the noise itself is not, in big bold letters, an essential element in the definition of an explosion. The generation and violent escape of gases are the primary criteria of an explosion. So that alone says they should have tested for it. But then we also, the NIST has lied, and we can prove it. As soon as the new investigation happens, the evidence is out there for you to see right now. We have 118 first responders who reported explosions. We have the radio transmissions from FDNY members that are still recorded today that reported explosions. We have audio recordings. We have video recordings. I've personally talked to witnesses that heard them. So there's nothing short of saying they lied, and they need to be held accountable. And besides that, like I said, there is no excuse for not testing for explosives. And so at the very least, at the very best, even if you want to believe the official story, this was the most incompetent investigation of all time. And I've talked to a lot of investigators that were there, and I asked them the specific question, why did they refuse to test? They weren't the ones who refused, but NIST did. And they said, all we can say, all they can answer is incompetence, or they tell me to shut up. They cannot give me any reason that follows national standards. So, but the reality, after all the research everybody here and the incredible people we're in the room with today have done, the reality is it was a criminal investigation to cover up the crime. So, I'd like to read a quote. This is from a retired, decorated FDNY lieutenant. Anyone who knows the fire service, he is a stud. He worked on Ladder Company 26, Rescue Company 3, Rescue Company 1 in his career. Anyone who knows, those are amazing companies. Here's his comment. Trade Tower 7 by itself is the smoking gun. Not hit by an aircraft with only a few relatively small fires, it came down in a classic crimp and implosion, going straight into its basement, something only very precise demolitions can accomplish, which takes days, if not weeks, to prepare. The 9/11 Commission didn't even mention it, and FEMA actually stated they didn't know why it collapsed and left it at that. Brothers, I know that the above implications are hard, almost unthinkable, but the official explanation is utter nonsense, and 343 of our murdered brothers are crying out for justice.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Mr. Eric Lawyer, Firefighters for 9/11 Truth. My God, where will it end?
This concludes our historic press conference event celebrating the over 1,000 architects and engineers who were able to momentarily suspend their disbelief long enough to consider the evidence and who have ultimately concluded that the government's conspiracy theory is a classic cover-up. If you have already done the same, or if you have questions and need more information, please visit our website, ae911truth.org.